Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn another poem, No Men Are Foreign. Here, foreign represents to the other country of any part of the world. See, there are lots of different kinds of nations and different kinds of people live on the same earth. Some are English, some are Chinese, some are the Japanese. Like this way, different continent have different culture, different size, type, shape and size of people. We sometimes find lots of difference from one nation to another nation, from one color complexions to another nation's color complexions, one culture from another culture. There are lot many differences, but finally, we have to remember that we all are human being. We all have the common place to live, that is earth. We all have the common air to breathe. We all feel the same way when we are hurt. We all have the same color blood in us. Here the poem also is all about the commonness of human being. The poet tries to convey that though we have lot of differences among us, but we should not forget about our basic inherity, our basic humanity. So let us start now. Remember, no men are strange, no countries foreign. Beneath all uniforms, a single body breathes like ours. The poet tells us that we should not differentiate from one place from another, one nation from another. No countries are actually foreign. Whatever the country is, but all it is on the same planet Earth, the same place where we used to live, that is Earth. Beneath all uniforms, whatever the culture of their dressing senses, whatever the way of leading the lives of people of different places, but a single body breathes like ours. Each body used to breathe the same way like us. The land our brothers walk upon is earth, like this in which we all shall lie. The land our brothers walk, here brothers word represents to the different nation and different kind of people all over the world, okay? They all are our brothers and sisters. So they walk upon the same earth like us. And one day, we will all have to lie on the same earth. Means everyone have to die and will be buried or burnt on this earth. They too, aware of sun and air and water, all the people of different places, they all are aware of sun. They feel the sun, air and water. They use the air and water. They are fed by peaceful harvests, by what's long winter starved. Their hands are ours. They are fed by peaceful harvest. The farmers used to grow the crops, whether it is in India or Japan or China or Bangladesh or America, anywhere, the farmers used to grow the crops and the whole world, the whole people in the world, they used to consume it, the peaceful harvest. By what's long winter starved, during the war time, starvation is a common epidemic form which used to grow or rise in all over the world. After the war, all the nations used to suffer the same way. Their hands are ours, and in their lines we read, their hands are ours, means we used to be the power of the other people. For example, the factory owner or the industrialists, they used to grow up in their life economically, financially, economically, whatever the way, but with the help of our hands, means with the help of the employees. So wherever, means each one of us are actually dependent upon some other people. That's why the poet conveys, their hands are ours, and in their lines we read, a labor not different from our own. And in different other countries, in other languages, poem and stories, when we used to read, we can find that there also, in their place, the people also used to work as a labor like we do in our country. Remember, they have eyes like ours and wake or sleep and strength that can be owned by love. The poet tells then that we should not forget that all the people in the whole world, they have the eyes and ears like us. The eyes which wake and sleep like the way we used to do. And they used to find the strength or feel the strength when they are in love. In every land is common life, and that all can recognize and understand. In every land, in every continent, in every corner of the world, there is life, there is people, there is the existence of life over there, and they all have the common similarities which we all can recognize and understand. Let us remember, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, it is ourselves that we shall dispose as betrays and condemn. Then the poet conveys very, very important message to all of us, that we should remember, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, when the politicians or the powerful people, when they used to, we should always remember that some politicians, some powerful people, for their own benefit, they used to create war. They used to create some situations that the common people used to fight among themselves. Okay, so the poet tries to convey that we should remember that whenever someone tells to hate our brothers, we should not forget that it is ourselves, only human being, that we shall dispose as betrays and condemn. We used to betray, we used to condemn to other people, we used to dispose, we shall dispose. Remember, we who take arms against each other. Poet also says that, remember, only human being used to take arms. Here arms means different equipments for warfare. So, we used to take arms against each other. Next, the poet finally says that it is the human art that we defile. It is the human art that we defile. Only human being on the whole world is responsible for defiling or polluting the earth. Our hills of fire and dust outrages the innocence of air that is everywhere our own. Our hills of fire and dust outrages innocence of air. Our hills of fire, that means the pollution created by different factories and industries. The smoke, the dust, it actually are, these all are polluting the fresh air that is everywhere our own. Remember, no man are foreign and no country is a strange. Finally, the poet once again reminds us that we should not differentiate from one people to another, one nation to another, because no men are foreign and no countries as a strength. There are no strange countries, there are no foreign country. We all are sharing the same place, the earth, sharing the same air, sharing the same water. So we should not differentiate and create enemies or problems in us. So this is really very wonderful poem. Hope you have understood it. Listen to the lecture explanation again. It will help you to understand it properly. Thank you.